Okay, so this guy, he like follows me into the NCR, right? And it's like, how did you get in here? Okay.
All over the place. The easiest place to find them is unopened bottles.
This guy, I'm pretty sure he's supposed to talk to me like after I get the Sunset Sarsaparilla cap or whatever.
Hoping someone will finally collect enough caps to create treasure. Other than bottles.
This is like a while after, and I'm just inside Helios 1, and this guy just pops up behind me right as I'm trying to kill these guard dogs, and it's like, how did you even get inside Helios 1?
No problem. If you're doing... Watch out!
Yeah, I probably would watch out, because there's just a bunch of guard dogs in here. Which, and I'm just, like, murdering these guard dogs, and this guy comes up behind me, like, Ayo, dog. This game is really great. The problem with this, just like the way it works, is that, you can never tell for sure where you're supposed to, like, be going, because the minimap doesn't work very well. I'm pretty sure you could sabotage the rockets if you had enough science. I like to imagine they're just broadcasting this. Just have like one of those mini radio broadcasters. Come fly with me, come fly, fly. Okay, so I'm gonna go with. I mean, speech is useful. I'm gonna go with a little in repair. A little bit in medicine, but I'm also gonna use speech.
I'm gaining on him.
I got you, Victor.
I follow you
for a while.
Howdy, partner.
What do you think you're doing?
get stuck on stuff. See, I figure I'll never get lost because Victor obviously knows where he's going. Not that they made the robot the same speed as you, so that you can actually keep up with him. And even if he was like slightly faster, it would probably still be possible. I mean, it'd be a little harder, but it'd still be not too difficult because the robot just gets stuck on stuff all the time. Or I guess not all the time. I do hope that by upgrading my speech, I'll be able to not have to collect 2,000 caps to get into New Vegas. That's would probably be good. I don't think I ever got really very far past the New Vegas section. I got to New Vegas, and then I met up with Benny, and then that was pretty much it. And then I started playing on my Surface for a little bit, and of course the game just decided that it wanted to reset. I mean, I restarted on my Surface, but then because of Steam cloud saves, it actually deleted my original save. I say it was probably my fault that it did it, but you know, either way, my original cloud save got deleted. And so, you know, I had to restart from the place. Which is good because it gives me an excuse to cheat because, you know, oh, I've been
here. Howdy, partner!
What's up?
Yeah. Yeah. Where did Victor go? Hello. I was going to see if I could hitch a ride with him to get into New Vegas. But hopefully with my speech so high, I can just, you know, smooth talk the robot.
We've got stuff we're not even allowed to sell, people.
Oh.
Only at Mick and Ralph's.
Ugh. That's like a really crappy town. I remember there were just people attacking me randomly. Wow, this place sucks. So, never stop moving.
No,
don't you dare. Jeez.
Case.
What's going on?
You've got nothing.
What are you doing? Did I kill you? But why are they shooting people? Oh, they're shooting thugs? Okay. I guess I'll help.
You look new to Freeside.
Okay.
So here's a little.
This is a funny part because he tries to run in the robots like kill him. It's a lot cooler the first time.
Submit to a credit check, or present your passport before proceeding to the gate. Trespassers will be shot.
Oh, it's science! No! Oh, no.
I'm sorry, but your balance does not mean...
Oh, darn.
If you are unable to meet the minimum balance requirement, an official passport is a...
How do I get an official passport?
When you have sufficient caps or passport.
No, I should have been upgrading science.
Screw you, Robo.
Submit to a credit check. Please.
Da, 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 da.
You have been warned. Extermination imminent.
Oh, I needed the key. Oh, jeez. Oh, jeez. Well. Okay, it says I can't fast travel because enemies are nearby. There's no one. Oh, wait. Is there. What is that? Someone if they don't have any money. I'm like, seriously.
I'm out of here.
Good luck with that. Oh no, you're not. You're dead. Sucks. Looks like Decker just got wrecked. Ooh. Okay, so I'm gonna go through the scrapyard and find a bunch of scrap to sell that lady.
he's up to 490. How does that happen? Always probably when he kills. Make sure I'm heading in the right direction. I swear, I remember there was like a mountain, like there was a mountain, so it was some sort of like trader or something, but. It's not a rock. No. It's just texture. What is this? Friend? Been here.
Welcome to Jacobstown, human. You're free to walk around. Just don't stare at the night cam. They don't like people looking at them. And if you're NCR, keep it to yourself. They're not popular around here. Doc's inside the lodge.
Thanks.
Same as any civilized town. Don't start any fights or steal anything. We'll treat you fair. Not a lot to ask.
Better watch out. Lily's been babbling about a grand kid to tell.
Maybe what you do. When you're like 60, okay, not 60, like 80, or you're about to die, or something, you become a ghoul on purpose. And then, that way, you live for another like 200 years.
Another human. One was enough.
Wow, that's so rude, and actually racist.
I assume this is a... It's neural degradation. Biomed gel can only preserve a living brain for so long, so you'll need to find a replacement.
I
haven't left Jacobstown in years, but there was one woman in Novak, Gibson. I remember her living with a pack of Pommies. Aside from her, I know that the Fiends and Caesar's Legion fight alongside dogs. There could be viable specimens among them, if you can get to them.
So, I'm going to...
I heard somebody whisper, please adore.
Okay, I'm not going that far. Jeez. Gibson.
Without a dream in my own.
Over there. I'm gonna go with Gibson.
Without a love of my own.
What? I've been there, though. Hey, well, I discovered Jacobstown. I'd say that's good enough for log on, I guess. That's, yeah, log, New Vegas log one. Hopefully I can find an SD card or something to put this on. The end. What was this?
Shots fired. Oh. They're gone. I'm sure it was nothing. I do need to find Lady Gibson, though. Okay, which one of them is Lady Gibson? She's to the right of the scrap yard.
So, you're back. Dr. Henry? Now, there's a name I haven't... As for your request, it's a bit ghoulish if you ask me, but Ray is pretty old, and I'll probably have to put him down soon enough. As for the price for this favor, 700 caps sounds about...
I'll screw you. Okay. I hate gathering cats. It's just really, really boring. I just walk around scrap yards collecting crap. So, you know. And, I mean, it's not like I'm spawning in some awesome weapon or something. I don't know why I have to justify this to myself. Oh, whoopsies.
Thank you.
that was a horrible. It was just like, and then it just like blood spurted out of the ground. I think there was a dog there actually. Jesus. So that was fun on a bun.
Okay. So I realized basically making vlogs of what's happening in Vegas. I was gonna try and not make very many, because I figured if I logged the entire thing, I'd probably remember it really well. Which is why it's cool when there's only like a few records of what happened, as opposed to this many. The problem is I'm not sure if I'll really feel so much nostalgia for Vegas as opposed to what I did for, like, seeing all the old, you know, Minecraft world I did. Maybe you don't.
Again, you interrupt me. Very well. Show me what you brought so that I can analyze
it. There might be like a jump in quality here.
All right, let's see here. Neural pathways look good. Definitely a breed of guard dog. If I transplant this brain into Rex, he'll be a bit more ferocious in his attacks. Have a seat.
Jeez. I mean, you think about it, this may well be a different dog. Or it may as well be a different dog. Next, I'm gonna do... CNs. Biology. I hope I'm not like watching this with friends or family. Then if I curse, it would be really awkward. When you say no, I wouldn't be. It's a sin to tell a law. Is it? Jeez. Be sure it's true. When you say I love your mother. Oh, actually, I don't lie very often. Except when I do. There are a lot of little white lies. Well, that's not very nice. Ugh. So, does anybody not like me? So, no. Oh, thanks, friend. Preside, Great Cons, the NCR. Everybody likes me. Even the Great Cons. Like, I have a good reputation with the Great Cons and the NCR. When you say I love you. Do you think the NCR would just, you know,
I love you?
The weird thing is that's a completely fake cough. I just do that because then, you know, it makes it sound like it's actually really difficult to make my voice go that high.
It's not really.
Okay, maybe that high.
Oh, no, I can do this.
It just kind of goes like this a little bit. I can see that Lone Star. Love this song. Whenever I do this, I'm just rapidly increasing the file size. More bitrate, please! I like the song. I'm gonna do this one now. What? No, I didn't cheat. Hopefully the other logs get deleted accidentally. I like hay. No, I don't. I'm probably allergic to it. Not like deadly allergic. No, I don't know. I'm explaining it to myself. In dreams I see them now, though
it seems I'm bound to roam. My thoughts are still of Texas and our business is with the muties.
Oh no!
Just doing what I'm paid to do. Harass the muties until they leave or attack us. If they leave, we'll let them go. If they attack, we wipe them out. Either way, the job's not done until they're cleared out of the town. I faced down a charging Deathclaw and didn't blink. What makes you think I'd back down from you? We're still owed half.
Jeez.
Won't name names, but some important folks in the NCR are sick of muties attacking their Brahmin herds. They want them gone from NCR.
So,
yep.
You know, I was thinking, right? Save. Bye. Oh, and wow, yeah, okay. That was poor choice of action, you could say. Okay, well, I'm thinking now, maybe, what I'll do is get these. And, like, I'm gonna do some. No one dared to ask his business, no one dared to make a slip. The stranger there among them held a big iron on his hip. Can I call the NCR, like, against the NCR? It was early in the morning when he rode into the town. This is hard. We come to a peaceful arrangement. But I'm thinking, It was early in the morning when he rode into the town. He came riding from the south side, slowly looking all around. He's an outlaw. Jesus. Oh, Rex, you idiot, no! Norton! Oh, wait, no, I wanted him dead. Okay, I have a better idea. He came riding from the south side, slowly looking all around.
Can't wait to get the rest of our pay for this job. Running came the whisper from each lip, and he's here to do some business with a big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip. Can't wait to get the rest of our pay for this.
What? In this town there lived an outlaw
by the name of Texas Red. Job.
Many men had tried to. Yep. Only I had five more. Should have spent. Instead of upgrading like random crap.
Something on your mind?
No, I'm not gonna do that.
That was a dent in the town treasury. If that's what it takes to be rid of them. He came here to
said it didn't matter. He was after Texas Red.
After Texas Red.
Wasn't long before the story was relayed to Texas Red.
What?
But the outlaw didn't worry, men that tried before.
A deal's a deal.
20 men had tried.
It's much cooler up here.
20 men
I love it.
Had made a slip. 21 would be the ranger with the big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip. The morning passed so quickly.
Hey.
It was time for them to meet.
Something on your mind?
Jeez.
It was 20 past 11 when they walked
good.
Out in the street.
Glad you didn't kill them. Letting them walk away folks proves we're not bloodthirsty mutants. If NCR or anybody else is looking for an excuse to attack Jacobstown, they're not going to get it from us.
That's a good idea. There's Keen.
Smart, charismatic, and hell of a mean streak. Doesn't care for humans, prefers fighting them to talking. He's got a lot of pull with Nightkin, though. He talks, they listen. Well, I was hoping he could draw the Nightkin to Jacobstown. Keen is saner than most, but I know he's thinking of going his own way again. He's aggressive, impatient, can't stand sitting around.
There before them lay the body of the outlaw on the ground.
So he might have went on living, but he made one fatal slip when he tried to match the ranger with the big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip.
Better go.
Big iron, big iron.
This is always like that part of the game where you're not quite sure what to do. Right, or at least I think so. Like, I am completely clueless. As to what I'm supposed to be doing here, really. I mean, I know the main storyline of Fallout New Vegas is that,
Hey, you're the one who's been going around helping people around here, right?
Yeah?
The king says to keep up the good work. He said to give you this.
What is it? Maize? Wow, thanks so much for the corn. Jesus, come on. I'm thinking, like, he's gonna give me some golden gun that gives me, like, a billion damage. No, he gives me corn. Seriously? It is literally corn. It's not like special, it's just corn. Jeez, come on. Corn? They told me to give you this. Have some corn. Thanks for, you know, doing all, thanks for helping so much. Have some corn. I really would have preferred like 100 caps. Or even like 10 caps, I would have preferred to corn. Even if corn is worth more than 10 caps, I would have preferred 10 caps because it's just such an insulting thing. It's like if I went to a restaurant and tipped you like 2 cents, you would have probably preferred me to tip you nothing because 2 cents isn't worth much of anything to you, is it? Hope not.
So it's like, seriously, mate, what are you doing?
Okay, what am I supposed to, what am I doing in this quest? It's like, come on, corn! Are you serious? Okay, so I need to get... my arm is itchy. I'm investigating rumors of free food, or optionally talking to those guys. Okay, so it's like right in front of the door? What? Maybe it's here. What's happening? am I supposed to go? Oh, whatever. The more I do this, the more I'm gonna have to compress this crunch biscuits. Okay, where the crap am I supposed to be going? Okay, it should be right in front. Here. Right. More. More. Is it here? Is this? I'm really confused. More. Train station or something, wasn't it? Ow, ow, headache, ow, ow, ow.
Hello.
It must be something to do with this, right? Should be right on top of it, like. I am just clueless. What is happening? In this town there lived an outlaw by the name of G.I. Blues. Many men had tried to take him, and that many men were dead. a bunch of movies.
And the notches on his pistol numbered 1 in 19 more. 1 in 19.
This must be a broken quest or something, because it's just.
Now the stranger started talking, made it plain to folks around.
Investigate rumors of food and water.
He came here to take an outlaw back alive or maybe dead. And he said it didn't matter, he was after Texas Red. After Texas Red. Wasn't long before the story was relayed to Texas Red. But the outlaw didn't worry, men the tribe before were dead. 20 men had tried to take him, 20 men had made a slip. 21 would be the ranger with the big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip. The morning passed so quickly, it was time for them to meet. It was 11:20 when they walked out in the street. Folks were watching from the windows, everybody held their breath. They knew this handsome ranger was about to meet his death. About to meet his death. There was 40 feet between them when they stopped to make their play. And the swiftness of the ranger is still talked about today. Texas Red is not cleared leather for a bullet fairly ripped. And the ranger's aim was deadly with the big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip. It was over in a moment and the folks had gathered round. There before them lay the body of the outlaw on the
okay,
ground.
So according to this, you're supposed to hire him twice.
When he tried to match the ranger with the big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip. Big iron.
Or, wait, no.
Big iron.
What?
When he tried to match the ranger with the big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip.
I have no idea. Oh, what am I doing? GI Blues, that's what it's called. Okay, so question about, and so first, hire a guard. Return. Go to the old fort. Ask about interlocals. Check about soldiers. Right after the soldiers.
Meets an old immovable object like me. You can bet.
Okay, wait.
Sure as you live.
Shady Sands, two-headed bear.
Something's gotta give, something's gotta give.
The rot face. If you fail the
that irrepressible smile such as yours warms an old implacable heart.
You can also speak the rot face password for
don't say caps. No, cause I insist
we'll sell it to you for 50 caps.
Somewhere, somehow, someone's gonna get kissed. So on guard. Knows what the fates have in store.
Okay, then conflict with the kings.
From their vast, mysterious sky.
What?
I'll try hard.
Okay, I should talk to Elizabeth. Kirin.
I adore.
Talk to Major Elizabeth Kirin.
Can anyone try?
Where is she?
Chances are some heavenly star.
Elizabeth.
My life is gonna be beautiful.
Hey. Hey. Oh, you're the guy who's saying hi all the time.
Tell me quick, ain't love a kick in the head.
Elizabeth. But that's a bit of tannin. Like, whoa.
is this Back to the Future? And he's like, no. I'm like, oh, your name isn't even close to it, damn it. None of these are Elizabeth. Rah! Who is that? Where? What? Why? When? Ah! Okay, so it wants me to go, like, right under the highway, right?
Hello.
I'm so confused and I have no idea what's happening. I have an idea. Maybe... there's someone... Oh, God. Darn it.
Hey, it's Mr. New Vegas letting you know I've got a new Christmas compilation coming out soon. Nuclear Winter Wonderland. Look for it on holotape. We've got some news for you coming right up. Tensions are brewing in Freeside between the ruling gang known as the Kings and the large number of NCR squatters seeking refuge there. The leader of the Kings, who would only identify himself as the King, voiced his displeasure calling NCR citizens, quote...
I give up.
Oof.